But I really sense in my spirit that somebody got something right now. It might not be everybody, but you touched something that your generation will not recover from.
Amen.
And you've been praying for just your need, your want, but you did not know that it was a means to an end. God kept you in that situation because he was wooing you into another dimension. Have you seen how they pour corn on the ground for chickens to come into the house? And the provision is in the direction of something else. He follows the corn into another place where his destiny is decided. The good God too has put you where you are. You see, sometimes we think that we linger, we wait so long that subconsciously we begin to assume that the devil is more powerful than God. We don't say it, we don't declare it, we know it's heresy, we know it's apostasy, but our mindset, because of the longevity of what we're going through, we have accepted some things as the will of God or the destiny of our souls because we have clinged to them already. We found a way to manage what God didn't plant. We built an ecosystem around things that are not God's original intent. Little did we know that if we step up to the responsibility God has called us to, those things naturally drop off. Listen to me, there's a difference between healing miracles and miracle healings. I've been in the power ministry for a while. When you pray for somebody and then they get healed gradually, it's different from praying for somebody and then they get healed instantly. You know the difference? The difference is the sound. I will explain it to you. When you get healed gradually, what happens is that what was in you left you. When you get instantly, you left what was in you.
Yeah.
It's a deep, that's why I tell you, when you make this sound, what happens is you are caught up. That's another level of exposure. You don't grow into something. No, you're not supposed to grow into everything. You don't have enough life years to grow everything. Yeah. There's some things that you must, you see, that's why the Bible declares that at the last trump, there will be a rapture. There will be a catching up. Because every time there is a sound in the spirit, something in the earth is caught up to it. And I cannot guarantee that you will hear the last trump and be caught up if you didn't hear the second to the last trump. And the trump before the second to the last trump. And the trump before the second. Every time you raise a sound like this, it's a trumpet that's blown in heaven. And you are supposed to be caught up to another level. There is a final catching up. But before that one, there are dimensions in God that you are to be caught up to. And that's why if your faith walk has not led you to a place where the devil messes with you and you still know how to go into your room and lock the door and shout hallelujah, cry and wipe your tears and shout hallelujah and cry and wipe your tears and shout hallelujah, you do not understand this level of breakthrough. Because the one who attacked your job didn't attack you because he needs a job. The one that attacked your relationship was not after it for jealousy of what you have. It's because he wants to take your song. It is because he wants. He lost a sound in heaven. He was heaven's chief music director. When he fell, he didn't lose power. The Bible never recorded that Lucifer lost power, but he lost the capacity, the audacity, the authority to sing the song of the Lord. So when he attacks you, he's trying to take from you what he lost eternally. So when he attacks you and you shut up, you have done it. It is idolatry. It is now worship to the devil. Because your life is designed for sounds. So if you are not singing the Lord's song, you call it fear, doubt, and discouragement. You don't know that you are singing the enemy's song. Nature abhors a vacuum. The spirit too abhors a vacuum. There are no shades of gray. That's why it's important to make sure that you know the sound. Blessed are those that know the joyful sound. The joyful sound. They will walk, oh God, in the light of your countenance. There is a sound for your life. There is a sound for this season. And don't let the enemy takes anything from you and you let it go. Don't let him take your sound. Don't let him take your sound. That's why the believer must understand the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. You must understand it. Because it just doesn't tell you, it doesn't only tell you what you have. It exposes you to what the devil lost so that you understand your advantage. Are you guys with me? It's important to let that sound come out of you. It's important to know the sound. The sound that the Lord lost. The sound that meets his heart. was how to explain a shepherd boy by the name of David, who learned to play the harp in the middle of nowhere. And someday, he was talking warfare. Someday, he was talking royalty. Someday, he was talking all kinds of things that the elders do not know. And then when God looked down from heaven upon him, he said, this is a man after my heart. You know, there's something about pursuit and desire. Have you seen the lion chase an antelope before? There's something about it. He said, this is a man that is after, which means he's looking for my heart everywhere. You don't know a heart until you know the sound, because the heart is found according to the readings of its sound. Is this the sound? You don't pluck the heart to know where the heart is. You look for its pulse. It is the sound of God's heart that was David's pursuit. So every time he took the harp, he was not trying to gain pleasure. He was looking for the chord progression that aligns with what God is saying. So as in God's heart, it was a pulse, a rhythm, a spiritual harmony he was chasing. That's why every time he caught it, he just noticed that supernaturally, he's 17 years old, but when he touches a bear and holds his mouth, it is turning in two, because he touched God's heart. Are you guys with me? That's why you can't lose. If you lost your sound, you lost everything. So you prayed, you didn't get the answer, and you kept quiet. Did you keep quiet? Please don't let your need, your want be your limitation. Tell the devil you are aware. You are aware. That's why every time you worship God, God puts it on the devil's PA system. So he can listen to what he has lost and will never get. You will never get. Ever get. So every time he attacks you, it's your sound. If he takes your sound from you, you are like him. Because you are born without the Lord's sound. You are born again, but you don't have the sound that connects with the heart of God. That's why he's chasing. He knows you are saved. He knows you will make heaven if there's anything like that. He wants to make sure that your walk here is futile. Make sure that you leave no marks in the earth. That's his pursuit. He knows you are sealed with the Holy Ghost of Holy Spirit of promise. But he wants your salvation to be your personal secret for nobody else to know. Don't lose your sound. That's why we brought you out here. To tell you what the devil is really after. It's not your tears. They don't impress neither God nor the devil. Spirits don't understand it when you cry. It's a mortal stimulus response. But when you shut up, they get the signal. And when you stand up and still praise the Lord in the midst of pain, they also get the signal.
Yeah.
Just lift your hand and release a sound. You see, some of these things are spiritual. They're not just about voice, sound. It's a posture. It's a posture of heart where you just remove that thing that's bugging you, and then you shift your gaze on God. The sound goes up to him. He gets the notification that somebody trusts him irrespective of what they are going through. It beeps on his phone. That's the kind of people that get his attention. Am I talking to somebody
yes,
here?
Sir.
Lift your hand. Let a sound go out from you. Lift your hand, let a sound go out from you. Let a spiritual sound. I know you have issues. We all do. The difference really is the sound. What does heaven hear when you come around? What sound is heard from your life? Those are things that will count in eternity. They will play them back for you on the last day. Nobody will ask you how many cars you have or how many shoes you bought. But what did you do with the Lord's sound?